Assalamu alaikum.
In the most holy name of Allah, God, the beneficent, the most merciful, the all-wise, true, and living God, the creator of the heavens and the earth. We can never thank the supreme being enough. For whenever a people go astray from God's straight and righteous path, out of his incomparable mercy, he always raises up a prophet or a messenger before he punishes that people to guide them back to Allah's favor, back to his straight and righteous path. Therefore, I thank Allah God for Moses and the Israelite prophets and given us that great guidance called the Torah. I thank him for Jesus and the gospel or the Injil. I thank him for Muhammad and the Holy Quran. Peace be upon these worthy servants of Almighty God, Allah. But if I live to be the ripe old age of Methuselah, I can never thank Allah enough for loving black people so much. But his divine intervention in our affairs in the persons of Master Farid Muhammad, to whom praise are due to forever.
Yes.
He came to the hills of North America by himself. And he raised up from among us that messenger Messiah, the exalted Christ, the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. And we can never thank him both enough for that wonderful and perfect helper of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. He is the vicar of Christ, who I represent to you today, the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. I am so excited to greet you once again in the greeting words of peace in the Arabic language of Assalamu alaikum. Boy, it's all my eating until you're sleepy in the plate. You know, good food always makes you sleepy. And I thank Allah for the wonderful meal, the wonderful chef of my daughter Bashira, Shakira Muhammad. The Sheikh Guru said, "Mr. Stanley ain't playing. He got two plates."
Yes, sir.
I always love good cooking, and the spirit in the food is most important. You don't want no devil cooking your food.
No, sir. Come on.
You start having high blood pressure, arthritis, migraines, and all kind of other stuff that we don't want to talk about. But I am so happy, beyond words, to have my brother and my friend, Brother Sheikh Guru, and the wonderful community and this wonderful Beyonce, y'all. Hold up now. For the movie, I think it was Beyonce. If you like it, put a what? So he's getting married at Muhammad's Mosque number 15B on January 14th. My brother and my friend. We can be brothers and sisters, but that'll make us friends. A friend is one who shares the same mission as you. We share the same mission as our brother and sisters from the Moors Temple of Science. We share the same mission as our Hebrew brothers and sisters. We share the same mission as our Christian brothers and sisters. The nation of Islam, we know that we're one family. And we know that the enemy is trying to divide us with theology. Because they know that we are the people of God. They know that we love God. But they confuse us by saying, "Well, your ancestors were Moors." And the Hebrews said, "No, the hell they weren't. They were Hebrews."
All right, go ahead.
biological warfare.
Yes. Yes.
As soon as you leave this place, you say, oh, I got to stop by Kroger and get some death. Mm-hmm. I got to stop by Publix and get some death. But I'm not going to get no Cheetos. I'm not going to get no Doritos. I'm going to get a tomato. But that tomato is from Monsanto. And Monsanto has these genetically engineered tomatoes. I don't care if you're a vegetarian. You're still in the jaws of Satan. Because the pesticide and the herbicide is feminizing the black man. And when the black man got a broken wrist, I can defend his women and children. I don't know what real woman wants a brother that goes victorious. But don't feed him the wrong food then.
Yes, sir.
If you don't want the man to be feminized, know that your pharmacy is your kitchen. Don't say, baby, I don't feel like cooking, let's go to Popeye's. It might pop the man with it. By the hormones in the chicken. And you might get jealous because he got bigger breasts than you. You know the commercial of Brother Eric? If you're taking this medicine and start developing breasts, please stop taking it. Do you know that we are in the jaws of Satan and don't even know it?
Yes,
with our bow tie on, with our kufi on, with our, you know, fez on, our garment on. If we don't get land that we can call our own and start growing our own food, I don't care what you call yourself, Muslim, Hebrew, Christian, Jew, let's get a land that will be ours as black people and feed our people.
Yes, sir.
This is a three cause that when we bind them, it's very hard to be broken. And what is that? And I close. Love. Faith. And knowledge. When you love God, the Creator, and you said, oh Allah, oh Yahweh, oh God, oh Jesus, whatever you call him, I love you. And the Bible says, how can you love God whom you've never seen and hate your brother, hate your husband, hate your wife, hate the Hebrews, hate the Moors, temple of science, hate the Nation of Islam, hate the Christians who you see every day? Your love for God has seen how you treat your black brother and sister. And if you hate your brother and sister, your love for God is hypocrisy. Love is a verb. Love is not what you say. Love is what you do.
All the time.
And I'm tired of going to funerals.
Yes, sir.
Brothers dying. 60 years old and all their children come. And what do you leave them? 60 years and you ain't got nothing you can leave for your children? But you say, I love you. Love is a verb.
That's right.
You can't tell a woman you love her and she going to breathe ain't nothing now. You can't tell her you love her and say, come on baby, let's go to the Salvation Army shelter. And then here comes the sunrise and you lay on your backside and you don't do nothing to take care of that woman. Your love is hypocrisy.
Yes, sir.
We make $1.3 trillion as a people. That's more than the whole country of Mexico.
Wow.
Right? Don't you talk about the Mexicans. They're better than we are.
Come on.
They just got over here and they own stuff on Cuba Highway. They got their own Mexican grocery store all over Atlanta. And they're working for $8 an hour
Right.
They're making their own tortillas from scratch and they sell them to the grocery store.
That's right. Yes, sir.
And they leave their children. A restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
A grocery store.
That's right.
But we got so much. I know God. Really? Look up in the sky. What do you see? You see treasures of sun, moon, and stars.
Right.
You know that, man? Hell, you do. How do you know God, who has the wealth of the earth, and you a bum? But you got your Holy Quran, and a bum ain't done nothing for your family. Don't you come outside your house talking about you gonna teach me religion and your house is not in order. Don't you come out your mouth and tell me you know God and your children are in the street smoking, cracking, drunk. Don't you come here with that hypocrisy.
That's right.
I didn't mean to say it. I have my notes here.
Speak from the heart.
Teacher, Bashir really cooked today.
Yes, he did.
I'm sorry. We have to put aside the books. Take off the garment. Take off the bow tie. Take off the fez. Take off the goofy. And put the labels to the side.
That's right. That's it.
And let's just wear the garment of love.
Yes, sir.
Right.
Yes,
sir.
Let's wear the garment of faith, knowing that Galatians 5 and 6 is faith that works by love. I don't know how God is going to unite our hearts, but I know he will do it as long as I'm sincere and I love for my brother what I love for myself. I love for my sister what I love for myself. If I have a bowl of soup, half belongs to my brother.
That's right.
Our love will be tried.
That's right. Yes, sir.
Every day.
And I want to close with this. In the Holy Quran, chapter 8, verse 63. Listen to these words. And he, Allah, has united their hearts. And if thou hadst spent all that is in the earth, thou couldst not unite their hearts. But Allah united their hearts. Surely he is mighty and wise. If we want to unite our hearts, and the heart is the way we think.
Yes.
See, we could be in here, smile and say, yeah, love and unity. But then leave outside this place. They ain't got what we got.
That's right.
We superior. We the one. We this and we that.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
You know, FBI agents wear bow ties, you know.
Yes, yes sir. They do. What? Yes, sir.
FBI agents wear coupes and beds, you know.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, they do.
All the time.
And then sometimes they're the most so-called devout followers because their objective is to rise up in ranks and get next to the leader and whisper in his ear, because when they start moving towards unity, don't hang out with them moose.
Yes,
you know who they believe in, right? Yeah, they believe in God, or who the hell you believe in.
Right.
Mm.
Come on.
They believe in Master Fahd Muhammad. So what?
That's right.
We do believe in Master Fahd Muhammad.
Yes, sir.
One day night.
And you do believe in whoever you believe in.
Yes.
But that's not the common denominator.
That's right.
And that's how you know the enemy, because they're going to exalt what we have in difference and not what we have in common.
Right, sir.
And what do we have in common? Trump calls us all niggas.
Yes, yes, yes. It's
a bow tie nigga, a fez nigga, a coupe nigga, a Bible toting nigga, we're all niggas to him. Am I right or wrong now? All you son of bitches.
That was
realizing that. The police are not trained to ask,
wait a minute. You believe in Noble Jerome Lee?
Yeah. He's not going to turn his gun away from you. He's going to shoot you 5 times.
That's right.
You believe in Yahweh?
Yes.
Absolutely. He's going to shoot you 5 times.
That's right.
I believe in Nation of Stone, Honorable Minister Farrakhan. He's going to shoot you 5 times.
That's right.
What was Sandra Bland? What, is she a Christian?
Absolutely.
Doesn't Trump profess he's a Christian? What I'm saying to us is, let's be more wise than what we are doing.
Yes, sir.
Satan's pattern never changes.
Never changes.
And he has already come among us.
Uh-huh.
I bear you witness. And you still have house Negroes among them.
That's right.
Agent provocateurs in every house of God. And you have hypocrites.
That's right.
Who say they believe, but they're not believers.
That's right.
I'm going to tell you how they work.
Uh-huh.
They're going to come to you, leadership. And they're going to whisper in your ear. They're going to probe you first. You really, with that Stanley Muhammad guy? You really, that Peru fella?
Right.
That's how they talk. You really with that pastor fan? I heard something about him.
Uh-huh.
Really? Did you? 1 second.
Exactly.
But Stanley, you on speakerphone. One of my members said he heard some about you, and I didn't want to finish. I wanted to finish it. Why are you doing that? I got weak.
Right.
That's all, folks. This was supposed to be a confidential conversation.
Right.
Uh-oh. And the same with Brother Haru. I heard something about tipple number 19.
Right.
You on speakerphone? I finished, Brother Haru. Are you on the line?
He said, mm-hmm, he's right there.
That's how you expose the enemy.
Yes, sir.
And then when you do that, then you are now weeding out the bad company.
Yes.
And 1 Corinthians 15 and 33 says, bad company corrupts good character. Be not misled. No one rotten apple in a barrel of good apples at one brown spot will make your whole group rotten.
That's right.
You gotta weed out the bad rotten apple quick.
That's right.
So let's conclude with this. Jesus in the book of John, chapter 10, verse 16. His disciples, and look, these are men are cast out demons, but not in your name.
Yes, sir.
Wow.
Go ahead.
Well, I see my Hebrew brothers. Look how clean my brother looks.
Yes,
look how clean his wife looks.
Right.
They got 90 acres of land
right. That
they can't wait to use to feed and help black people. Look how clean they are. Brother Haru looked to this wonderful fiance, the group that's with him, and the group that's with our Hebrew. Look how clean the MGT looks and the FOI look. We're all sheep of the same creator. If the Hebrews stop you from drinking, stay with the Hebrew. If the Hebrews stop you from whoring, stay with the Hebrew. I don't think the Hebrews believe in whoring. They believe in marriage.
Yes, sir.
Come on.
Yes, sir.
I don't think the Moors, Temple of Sion will believe in going to Magic City.
No, sir. Absolutely not.
They believe in going to Temple number 19.
Yes, sir.
And finally, you are a beautiful Muslim Moor wife.
Yes, sir.
Not a girlfriend, right? Wife. But we believe the same thing.
Yeah.
What woman wants to be a part of the community and a man can be a whore and a woman can't?
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to be a whore anyway, do you?
Right.
when you have that kind of common denominator. Love. Faith. Faith of what? That we can take our money and build a nation.
Yes.
Can you see a grocery store with Hebrew green beans?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And Baptist corn.
Right.
And Methodist bean pie.
Right. Yes, sir.
Methodist bean pie.
They sure do.
And Nation of Islam, Turkeys. We all can have a grocery store that we all own it. And let's come together. And from this humble meeting, we're not going to let the knowledge that we have divide us.
That's right.
We're going to focus on the universal knowledge. We all believe in prayer. We just have different rituals of prayer. But it's still prayer.
That's right.
And Satan wants to use the rituals to divide us. They don't pray like you pray.
That's right.
But it's prayer. We all believe in what? Charity.
Yes, sir.
We believe in fasting.
Yes, sir.
We believe in giving back to the poor and helping the poor and suffering of our people in our community.
That's right.
Don't we all believe that?
That's right.
Well, how do we get divided? If we all have the same belief. And we all believe in the God that made sun, moon, and stars. How do we become divided? Because we still think one
God. That's right.
We don't want to admit that. Because it's only the white man's thinking that will cause us to glorify individualism. Divide and conquer.
That's right.
One said, Willie Lynch. Willie's objective was to divide the people of God. And I want to stop the division right now.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
How do we stop it? By us all coming together. So brother, can you come up here with me? This is not your brother. Come on. Give me a Christian brother or sister. Give me one Christian brother or sister. Ain't got no Christians in the house?
Thank you, no.
I think they all live.
Thank you.
Well, I'll be here representing the Christian.
That's right.
But I'm a Muslim Baptist preacher.
That's right.
These are my brothers.
That's right.
And we're not going to let no one divide
us. That's right. Go ahead.
And all of you are family.
That's right. Yes, sir.
And I love you with all my heart. I don't care what your religion is. We gonna come to your aid when
that's
you need
right,
it.
That's
we
right.
Gonna come to your aid when you need it.
That's right.
Matter of fact, they happened there wedding in Muhammad's mosque number 15 feet.
That's right.
What the devil think about that?
Go ahead.
And we can't wait to go and support my brother. Yeah, come on up here, y'all. Come on up here, Ruth. You can't go nowhere without a black woman.
That's right.
Oh, yeah. Only Brother Moody Theater could help you with that.
Mathematician.
Unity. Muhammad's Mosque number 15B. It's the 17th day today. B equals 2 in mathematics.
Go ahead, Brother Moody.
17 plus 2 equals 19.
Come on, man.
Tempo number 19.
Praise God.
And 9 represent there's a woman pregnant.
Right.
You see the legs and the womb?
Right.
And we're pregnant with love.
Pregnant with love.
And with this love, we can give birth to a nation.
Yes, sir.
Birth to a grocery store, birth to farmland, birth to a hospital.
even birds. He has woodpeckers. He has blue jays. He has hawks. He has all these different birds. But they're all a part of the same community. And they don't despise each other. They respect each other. And this bird, look at the bird. You see the wings?
Yes, sir.
And all of us have a different bird of knowledge. But these birds, they all have a connection to each other.
Yes.
And we have found the connection.
Beautiful.
Yes, sir.
And the connection is love.
That's right.
The connection is faith that we can overcome whatever difference we might have. And the knowledge that we have, we share with each other. And we build a future that we can call our own. So when we die, Brother Edward, when we make our transition, we can at least bring our children to our deathbed like Jacob.
That's right.
And Jacob only wanted to know, what will you serve after me? And the children of Jacob said, we will serve the God of Jacob,
right,
the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac. And then Jacob was able to go to the Lord in peace.
Yes.
But Jacob did not leave the children without land. He left the children without land, with land. And brother, we cannot die. We're not going to let you die. You ain't got time to die.
No, sir.
You try to die, I'm going to wake you up and say, wait a minute, you got some building to do.
That's right.
You die when we build for our children.
Right.
So let us plan after this day. I'd like to open up a pot. I'm going to test this unity. And I want to put some money in the pot. And that money is not going to be for the Nation of Islam. It's not going to be for the Hebrews. It's not going to be for the Moors. It's going to be for our people.
Right.
And let us use that money and buy some land,
yes,
here in Atlanta.
Yes.
And let's get some vegetables and start growing gardens right here in Atlanta.
Hi, sir.
That we can say that the Muslims, the Moors, and the Hebrews and the Christians put aside their differences and establish community gardens for our people. Isn't that beautiful?
Yes, sir.
And then what the surplus, we can sell to other communities. And we can go to the public and say, hey, you take them from our community, we want you to buy our fruits and vegetables.
That's right.
Y'all with us on that?
Yes, sir.
This is instruction of God's servant, the honorable minister who
inspired.
Let us build the wasted city. So thank you. Let's give them all a round of applause. And something wrong with us, is that right? But I'm putting my money where my mouth is. And so I need a good realtor that will find some land that we can own. It's not going to be ours, it's going to be for our people. For the community. I don't care what their religion is, what their condition is, it's for our people. Any hungry brother and sister can come and peep from that land and get something to eat. Isn't that beautiful?
I can be your realtor.
All right.
Oh, we got a realtor right here. Allahu Akbar. Brother, we want you to find some good land. And then we actually want the purpose. Yes, sir, brother. Eric?
I'm going to show you something that's going to run out of teaching people. Tell them to buy land. Sheldon Motherland 50 miles away from big cities, right? Why? He said there will be war. And he said when there is war, all the roads will be blocked. So he said, don't listen to the government to tell you that you're going to have access to the road. He said, no. He said, by the way, get 3 miles away from these cities, but preferably with waterway. Because he said, the waterway is never blocked. So no matter what, you can always communicate with other cities.
Wow.
You get access to a waterway. In fact, if you understood the beginning of the United States, that was a problem because the United States did not have access to the Mississippi River, which was the heart of America.
That's right.
Right? So they wanted to negotiate a part of Mississippi River so that they can have access to bring their commerce. Right? Because Mississippi River starts from Indiana all the way to the Great Lakes.
That's right.
Okay. So at that point, and not only that, it had also access to two other rivers, the Ohio and the Missouri. Right? So that means that was the heart of commerce. So now if you are talking, if we are talking about land, we have to follow their
path. That's right.
That's right.
That's right.
The messenger told us to observe the white man.
That's right.
He's successful in all his enterprises. So we have to observe. This is what they teach. So we can do the same. So now if you want to be the realtor, find ourselves land that are 50 miles away because one more thing he said you can use that land as either a survival club or you can do it as a vacation club because he said not too many people will want to subscribe to survival club, right? But if you say vacation club, you tell them how they can use it for their children, and that's when they will be more prone to come and invest with you. And if you got the land, you can put any kind of structure on it. Right? If there is war, everybody knows that they can have at least 2 million a day.
Exactly, sir.
That's it. We have to use the wisdom.
Thank you. And Brother Eric, and we'll sit at the table. Yes, ma'am.
I just wanted to say I definitely agree with Brother Eric with what he said. In addition to buying the land 50 miles out, we can also, and we need to still do some urban gardening where we put some container gardens on people's porches because they may not be able to get 50 miles out.
Yes, ma'am.
But if you are in the community, in terms of a pot, put something in the pot, put it on your porch, put it, you know, in a, you know, a square, you know, you can have your big rural farming and people like Harriet Tubman can tell you how to use the Underground Railroad and get provisions from the 50 miles back into the city underground. But at the same time, you have to have, she was able to get all the way north because she knew what house to go to that had a particular pot on the porch or in a backyard where she could grab a potato or this or that to keep her moving. So you have to do both in big land, rural, 50 miles away. Pots, container garden, right behind your house.
Right.
Where would we go without the black woman?
That's right.
So here we can merge and marry the beautiful wisdom that we heard from Brother Eric and Sister Kavah, because we need to actually deal with the food deserts in our community. And we need to deal with the strategy so when we push out and we have to flee the inner city, we will have a place to go and still feed our community. So let us all be in unison. Let's build and get some land we can call our own. So you have a pledge from Sister Ruth and Brother Stanley, $1,000 to establish that land. Because I know that if you look at all the prophets of God in the scripture, they left land for their children.
Right.
And we have to leave land for ours. And eventually we'll have land that we can get our own hospitals, our own factories, our own businesses. That's where we need to go. It's too much talking among us. We like to philosophize and preach. But now we should be in the book of Acts. Now it's time to do. Thank you very much. for a wonderful evening. Thank you for your spirit. And Brother Gerald, I want to thank our brother for bringing these wonderful, diverse communities together. He's my brother and my friend. Keep up the good work. And I think that we have, I don't know if we have time for questions, but I'll let Brother Gerald take it from here, and then we'll close out with a few questions. Thank you for that opportunity. Assalamu alaikum.